Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In this series, we'll see how to create a basic to-do list application. This is a part 1 video of this series. In this video, we'll see what app we are going to build and what role we need to know for this development. This is the app we are going to do in this series. On opening the application, we are showing a splash screen where we are showing the app icon with an animation. Inside we have a drawer menu and a fab button. On click of the fab button, showing a dialog for adding the task. Here we have a menu for a task which contains edit, delete, mark as complete and reset. Inside task we can add the subtask, naming the subtask as subtask 1. For subtask we have edit and delete actions. Also a checkbox for marking subtask status. Adding another subtask, now we'll make a subtask as completed. When all the subtasks marked as completed, then the task will be denoted by the striped font. To develop this app, we have some icon requirements. I will give this as a zip file in the description. I have a launcher icon, icons for menu and adaptive icon foreground. First, we'll create the application. I'm naming the application as to-do list. If you want to change the launcher activity name as splash screen, you can do it. I'm leaving it as main activity. First, we'll set up the app icon. So, we need to convert the app icon into all the required size. Inside the rest folder, we have all the mipmap folders. We need to replace the icons inside it. To resize the icon, I have created a page in my website. I will give the link in the description. In this page, select the option as Android app icon, then select the file you want to resize. Sorry, I forgot to take the square icon, so I'm copying the icons here for a backup. We need to select 512x512 or above size images. I'm selecting this image because I am not going to use this icon for Play Store display icon. Click on upload. Now we will get a zip file. Doing the same for the round icon. Once you open the zip file, you will see all the resized images inside appropriate folders. We need to replace the images. So I'm selecting all the files from the zip and dragging it here. Let's do the same for round icon. Note that I have same name as IC Launcher and IC Launcher Round, so it's replacing the icons. I want this IC Launcher Full as a drawable, so I'm selecting Android Drawable and dragging the icon. Let's upload and open the zip file. Now drag the drawable folders inside our rest folder. Now we'll add the icon in the layout file. Open activity_main.xml. Here, I'm changing the text view to image view and setting its width and height as 150 dp. Also, setting image sources IC Launcher Full. The icon is not coming on preview panel, so I'm syncing the project manually. You can see we got the icon here. To do animation on this icon, assigning ID as IC_logo. To store animation resources, creating a directory called anim inside our rest folder. We need to add the animation resources here. I'm going to splash screen tutorial inside app, src, main, rest and anim. We need splash in and splash out animation. So, I'm copying the file content and creating animation resources on our project. Now, we need to do the animation in main activity on top of IC logo. Starting the initial animation using startAnimation method. Inside pausing context, and splash in animation resource. This animation will happen for 300 milliseconds. After that, I want the icon to stay for some time. So, starting the end animation after 1.5 seconds using handler. The splash out animation will happen for 500 milliseconds. So, waiting for 500 milliseconds using another handler. Now, I'm hiding the logo and then starting the next activity. We don't have another activity to launch, so I'm creating a new activity called dashboard activity. Starting this activity by using startActivity method. After starting next activity, killing current activity by calling finish method, so that on press of back button, main activity won't be shown again. Now we'll launch the application. After showing the splash screen, we are getting the dashboard activity. But we have two issues. We have the toolbar in splash screen and app icon is not showing the proper one. To change the toolbar color, opening the colors.xml. Here I'm changing the color code for color primary and color primary dark. To hide action bar, open styles.xml. Here changing the parent theme from dark action bar to no action bar. To fix the app icon, in mipmap any DPI, we need to keep our app icon. Copying the foreground image inside our drawable folder and deleting the old XML file. For background, we need to set the color primary. So, I'm removing the drawable and setting the background as color primary. Doing the same for round icon as well. Now we'll launch the application. You can see we don't have the action bar on splash screen. Also, the icon is updated with the proper icon. In next tutorial, we'll see the database structure. That's all for this video, guys. If you want to support me, you can do that by becoming a patron at patreon.com/codeandroid. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.